I tell you, I was not thinking of taping today because the wow factor is just so strong. Continuity, fear, and the wow factor is just so intense. But I looked at the viewership, and I'm seeing that I'm, you know, there's still, you know, this consistent viewership. So I said, well, let me give it a try. And see how I can do. It's the content is just getting extreme, and apparently there's good reason for that. I did say that in by the June 21st, 2016, we had really better be completed on our preparations. Well, maybe I was off by here. I hope not. But the intensity is very interesting because right now is, what is, the 15th. I have not been following the news, but something came to my attention. Very odd. Let me fill you in on this. I came across this in a very indirect way, the notion of the collapse of the Late Bronze Age and how that was one of the mysteries of history, and how that happened. And they say that it had something to do with the Sea Peoples, they're called, who attacked and destroyed all these ancient civilizations. And the one of the hypotheses is that these people came from Greece, the Aegean area around Greece and Greece. And it's still an amazement that how such a small population of ragtag poor warriors could level these civilizations, and yet they did. It happened. So I just said, why am I studying this? I don't understand. This is quite odd. And then today I came across this mention of Greece, and there's some trouble with the European Union again. Well, this has been going on for how long? About 5 years or so? Long time. I said, oh, you know, they're still having troubles with Greece, huh? Well, apparently this one is pretty severe. And they're getting to this very strong line in the sand in Greece that they have to pay back this money. And I guess they elected some very leftist young leader who's saying, no, you know, we're not going to go any further. You're the ones who have caused us problems. And so there's this deadlock here with Greece. And then some people feel that Greece is the linchpin for ultimate economic collapse. It's tied very high, much tied to Cyprus, their banking system. And if Greece goes down, Cyprus goes down. And somehow this could cause the unraveling of debt problems in the world. This is one theory. And of course, most people just dismiss it, say, that's ridiculous. You know, how can a little country like Greece cause so many problems? Well, and suddenly I remember that this studying of the Sea Peoples and the collapse of the Late Bronze Age brought down these ancient empires, a number of them. And including Egypt, decimated Egypt, didn't bring it down entirely, but it really, really harmed them. And I say, wait a minute, you know, is there some sort of parallel here, where we don't see how it's possible that problems in Greek economic structure could cause a worldwide problems and bring about the collapse of the civilization? But that's the same thing that historians say about the Sea Peoples. How could it possibly happen? And yet it did. Coming from Greece is one of the main theories. Well, here we have Greece again. And I said, wow, there's some parallels here, aren't there? Now, the reason I'm mentioning this, I have not been talking about, you know, end time events too much, but I had a dream last night, and this mountainside suddenly turned into rubble and like mud and rubble, and it was like a huge flow of huge crumbling. This whole mountainside just crumbled away into mud and debris, and it was flowing down the hillside, the mountain, and it was so extraordinary. And then right in the midst of this complete collapse of this mountain, Jesus was there, and he spoke to me, and he said, you will find that now that overnight there will be those who wake up, and in the morning they will be in the now. That's what he said to me. They will be in the now. They will be dwelling, abiding in the now. It'll happen overnight, he says now. They will wake up in the morning from their sleep, and they will be in the now. And said, this is going to now happen. This is what's going to happen. And I said, wow. I don't remember if he said young people, some young people. I seem to have interpreted it that way in some ways, but I'm not entirely sure. But the gist of it was that there will be those who will simply wake up in the morning one morning, and they will be abiding in the now. This is what Jesus said, and I said, well, why is this mountain collapsing? What is going on? And this shows like a meltdown, some huge meltdown about to take place. And so we're looking at Greece as, you know, one of the flashpoints. And, you know, you start looking at what's going on with Russia and all the military maneuvers they're engaging in. They must know something is up. Russia must know something is really up. It has to do with Germany, you know, the EU, the whole thing. We can feel that something might happen. And so it very well might happen. I wouldn't be surprised at all. This ultimatum is in a couple weeks, which would put it at about the 29th of June. And some say that the problems will start in July. Well, that's what I was shown in a clarification over a year ago, that in July, somewhere in July, I put it about the 21st, but somewhere in July, there's the problems are really going to manifest. But I thought it would be 2016. I thought we had some time to prepare, but maybe it's this July. It's possible because this situation with Greece is going to come to a head one way or the other. So I've been pushing as fast as possible, and what I think is that there may be some who will wake up into the now, abide in the now, and then they will help others during this next year. I feel this next year is going to be one of great trouble in the world, and leading up to then July of 2016, where basically they will try to push through laws, and there'll be this draconian situation where everybody will be expected to anticipate the beginning of time, actually, and to be ready for that, and to have the attitude that we feel is going to be necessary for that, and that those that don't have this attitude will be, you know, severely compromised. So we need to be able to be confirmed and take refuge in spiritual practice. Full stop in the now. Full stop in the now. Everything liberated in the now. World liberated in the now. We need to be able to practice. So it may be that there will be those that overnight they will awaken, they will be abiding in the now, and they will be able to then help others and engage in right spiritual practice. Not dialogue anymore, practice. We've reached the point where the end of dialogue and the beginning of practice, because we must understand that the way the world is going to a new world order is that they want to end all discussion in favor of their ideas of what they believe is salvation, which is really for everyone to completely forget about reality. That's how the ego sees salvation. So they'll say, end of dialogue, no more dialogue. Well, we have to be ready for that ahead of time, or we have to say, no more dialogue with the ego. Since the ego is cutting off dialogue with us, okay, let's anticipate this and say, okay, fine. Yeah, we've cut off dialogue with the ego. Okay, we're abiding in the now. We are practicing, doing spiritual practice. We're not dialoguing anymore, because it's going to be cut off very soon. It's almost already cut off, actually. It's almost impossible to have a dialogue anymore in this world about truly meaningful issues, spiritual issues, which are the only meaningful issues there are. So we have Jesus now, like three times in the last month and a half, I've had experience with him, at least three. And so I said May 1st, he's back in this world, and get ready to start getting some guidance. And then the night before last, I had this guidance of don't engage in dialogue, spiritual practice now. You must start practicing. This was symbolized Jesus jogging past me, showing that you need to work out, need to consistently do spiritual practice instead of sitting. And then I saw some others who were sitting talking. And Jesus said, that's not it anymore. That time is now past. And then last night, appearing in this pyroclastic mud flow of mountain crumbling, absolutely whole mountain crumbling, which is astonishing. We thought it was all made of granite, but it's made of mud and dirt, and it's all crumbling. And he said, you know, there will be those who will simply overnight, wake up overnight, they're ready. So here we go, here we go. I've been getting glimpses of extreme clarity, but then the continuity fear arises, right? And I go right back into, like, did I see something? Did I really? Of course I saw it. But the clarity needs to come. So don't struggle. Remember, don't struggle with the struggle. Don't struggle with the wow. Don't struggle with the wow. This is the key to your success, because you will glimpse truth. And then you will go back into a shell a little bit. And you just say, okay, I went back into the shell for a little while. That's fine. And just praise yourself for your courage to view the truth. And then that will help you then take another peek, you know, take another peek and see it again. And that's really what spiritual practice is all about, is taking a little peek, a little more. And then you withdraw into a shell of continuity concern. And then don't, a wow feeling, like, wow, did I just really see that? Did I really do that? And then you just say, don't struggle with the wow. Don't struggle with it. Just accept it. You're going as fast as you can when you do it this way. Full stop in the now. Full stop in the now. Full stop in the now. You can say it to everything. Concrete. Full stop in the now. Or released in the now. Liberated in the now. Full stop in the now. Vegetation. Full stop in the now. Population. Full stop in the now. Mind. Full stop in the now. Thoughts. Full stop in the now. Reactions. Full stop in the now. So I oscillate between having great confidence to do this and to assert it in the world, and then going back to feeling like, oh, what are people going to say? What are they going to think of me? That kind of thing. And then you realize that's just continuity fear. And so don't struggle with it. Just shrug and say, okay, well, that's just continuity fear. It's mindless. It's mindlessness, really. One of the keys is to realize that how can you be ignorant of what doesn't exist and what will never exist? How can you claim that's ignorance? No, it's arrogance to assume that we can have knowledge of what can never exist. That's total arrogance. There isn't any such knowledge. It doesn't show a lack of knowledge to not know what can never exist. And arrogance is telling us that shows a lack of knowledge. This is nonsense. But it keeps using that technique, that trap. There's a mystic rabbi, I believe, in Israel, who recently had an experience in the cave of Elijah, and he prophesied that war is going to start in Israel, and that people need to repent and fast all over the world. And he brought up the number 44, which is a very important number that's been brought up to me many, many times. It's interesting. We're told that Elijah is going to appear before the end times. He said that Elijah appeared to him in this vision while in the cave of Elijah, where Elijah in Haifa, I think. And this is quite interesting. The various stuff that's going on in the world right now, right at this time, would seem to indicate that we're right on track. We're right on track. And we certainly have the tools to be successful. This whole practice that we have, walking together in the wow, is what enables us to be successful and successfully sidestep the outrage of the world. The world's going to be outraged at those who don't accept its version of salvation, which is indeed to disregard and reject truth and reality as much as we possibly can, to disavow it entirely if we, you know, and feel completely dispirited towards it. That's their goal, and they think that once they reach that goal, then that'll enable us to fully embrace the kingdom of time, and only through fully embracing it will we actually be happy with it. Of course, there's no such thing as time. There will be never be a kingdom of time. And trying to forget reality, trying to forget ourselves, is futile. It's like going into a dream of forgetfulness, and yet you're the dreamer. The dreamer, the dream is trying to forget the dreamer. You know, this is how silly it is. The dream is trying to forget the dreamer. And it's claimed that if the dreamer doesn't forget itself through the dream, that the dreamer will then lack knowledge of forgetfulness of itself. And of course, there is no true forgetfulness of self, and there is no time, and so there is no such knowledge. We won't be lacking knowledge to accept reality as it is. Now, world markets are starting to be a little bit disturbed by this Greece situation. The president of Greece is going next Thursday, I believe, when they need to give some response to the ultimatum. Well, there's some meeting, very important meeting, about the whether an ultimatum should be released. He's going to be in Russia, meeting with Vladimir Putin. There is a global chess game going on right now, very intense. And the United States is highly distracted. The population has been highly distracted by a bunch of nonsense. We haven't been distracted here, because right spiritual practice is what we need to do. We need to take refuge in spiritual practice. There may be those to help us do this. And they will have the right attitude. That right attitude is I've been, it's flickering in me. I can see it. I can see it again and again and again, where you're able to take a very firm, tough love stance and not be bullied or pushed around by anybody. It is possible to do that. And there may be some that are able to do that, and that will greatly help many in the world, who then will feel the courage to start practicing, and just at least get the rudiments of it. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. I am now, there is no me. I am now, there is no me. The me is but a aimless dream of what can never be. The me is but an aimless dream of what can never be, which is time. So I am now, there is no me. Me is but an aimless dream of what can never be. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So there can be a revival actually taking place. Jesus seemed to indicate there will be. And so we'll let that play out. There's a lot of wow factor about this. So I'm not going to try and analyze it or look at it too much. I don't feel able to do that. I've glimpsed it and keep getting clear and clear glimpses of it. So, and then I go, the fog comes in, a little bit of continuity fear, which is okay. It's great. It's just a matter of keeping the course steady here. So it may be the long-awaited troubles may be now about ready to commence. That is possible. Maybe they'll be delayed for one more year. It doesn't take a lot of practice, spiritual practice, to begin to gain a spiritual center, to start saying, wow, I really can center myself. I don't need to be dragged down by the demands of the arrogance, the ego, the world, that insists that I forget about reality, disavow it, renounce it, lose all faith, you know, faith in the Holy Spirit. I don't need to do those things. I can increase my faith, actually. It doesn't take that much effort. I believe that people really try for about a year of intense practice, spiritual practice, they will be, you know, really capable. It's just a matter of doing it is what people are having extremely difficult time with right now, is actually doing it. But it will take those who are abiding in the now to actually, you know, get the ball rolling. It will, because there's so much pushback right now, tremendous pushback. And yet Jesus indicated this will take place. This will take place now. Full stop in the now. Full stop in the now. Full stop in the now. What do we need to know about aimlessness? What is there we need to know about aimlessness, actually? Are we going to miss something by not focusing on the world? Is somehow we missed? If we don't focus on aimlessness, somehow we're missing something very important? What could that be? What could that be, the aimless? Aimlessness has something of value for us? No, it does not. So we have seen how events can happen just very quickly, like Russia taking over the Crimea and then going into Ukraine. Stuff can happen, actually. Stuff can happen. There may be a run on Greek banks. That's possible. There may be all sorts of very quick, you know, the wars usually are economic, based on economics. In the ancient world is often, you know, famine. The economics of famine are a drought. You know, economics of drought, and the women would say, "Hey, you know, our children need to eat. Guys, you know, get your shields and spears, and we'll get in the ox carts and let's go. There isn't any food here, and you see the people over there; they got food. Let's go, and your job is to capture that food, so the children can eat and the next generation can grow. So this is how it works." Yeah, the men are, you know, enjoying life, and then they get the message, hey, you know, that's over. You know, wartime, get your warrior groove on. you know, woe unto the man that goes home to his wife and says, nah, I don't really feel like that. I just feel like, you know, praying and taking it easy, and, you know, woe to that man, that is for sure. They get the message loud and clear that, you know, who's in charge, and they're told that they need to, you know, start invading. Apparently, this is what the Sea Peoples did. They were these invading forces were followed by women and children in ox carts. This is what a lot of the historical record shows. And throughout history, there have been huge invading migrations that, you know, the first come the men, the warriors, who try to destroy, you know, the resistance to the territories they're invading. And behind them come the women and children and the old and infirm in carts of some sort to, you know, settle in this new land. They call it new land. It's not new land. It was already occupied, of course. So invasion has happened over and over on this planet. We may have an economic invasion taking place right now. The hacking of all the people who have clearances, the United States government, and now, you know, Britain saying that that the spies and operatives have been compromised by Snowden's leak, and you can feel that there is certainly potential for things to start to unravel. And this is what I saw in the dream. It starts to unravel very badly. And then there's Jesus in the midst of it all, not being affected by it in any way, saying, you know, now's the time. Now is when there will be those who wake up. It's the story, you know, it's happened before. Eckhart Tolle talks about how he went to sleep one night and he woke up in the morning and the whole egoic complex was gone. It was just gone. So apparently that can happen just like that. I don't have any reason to disbelieve him. However he's gone about his business in the world, there's certainly some sort of awakening. And so it is possible that there be quite a few that will simply drop this whole, he called it the pain body or something. He has his own terminology, which it's whatever, you know. But we don't have to call it that. But it could be that we could give a different purpose to this dream, the dream simulation, which is preparing us for time to start. And we wake up in the morning and we're abiding in this, what's the now, which is really preparing for time not to start. That's what the now really is. From a standpoint of functioning here in perception, it's preparing for time not to start. And we're in this mental state of this is how we're experiencing the world now, the universe. And so there could be quite a few. In fact, Jesus said, this is what you should expect. This is what you should expect. So I'll go along with that. I don't know if I'll do it or not, maybe. Yes, it's really hard to say. I mean, how can you say it just drops away, you know, overnight? It'll be, well, it's certainly possible. Certainly is possible. It's kind of like you're losing a tooth when you're young and finally the tooth, you know, drops out and you say, wow, I didn't think it would ever come out, but eventually it did. So, and I feel that the role will be to get those who are willing to actually start practicing. This is the great shortcoming that we all suffer from, is we're unwilling to directly assert, you know, the truth of our being and our decision to give a different purpose to this dream simulation. So I am not a body, I am free, I'm still spirit exactly as God had created me. Full stop in the now, 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 full stop in the now. And it may be that people realize, wow, you know, this is what we need to do right now. It's no point tilting at the windmills of this extremely complex economic meltdown, and people realize, wow, it's forget it. Let's put our faith in that we can give the different purpose to the universe, and we absolutely can, to our universe, and by doing that, our universe completely supports us. Is in complete support, because that's part of preparing for time not to start, would mean dwelling in a universe that completely supports you and does not cause you any trouble whatsoever. Of course, it's time that would cause all the trouble. That's the way why this simulation is full of troubles, because the only way we can think of time, it would just be, you know, just incredible, massive complex of troubles and unexpected collapses and catastrophes and misery and death and all of this. And I saw today that death is nothing but a part of this rehearsal, dress rehearsal for time to start. That's all that it is. This is what we believe will be our fate once time starts. But that's all death is. It's just what we believe our fate will be once time starts. That is kind of odd, isn't it? All of the simulation is very odd, because time will never start. There's no such thing. We are just imagining what we believe or it might be like. And death is very much part of that. Again, death is nothing but a simulation, an imaginary simulation based on what we believe will be happening once in the kingdom of time. We'll have these bodies, and then these bodies will die. That everything will go through these cycles of birth and death, birth and death. All of it is nothing more than a dream from our imagination, spiritual imagination. All of it. And so I've been, you know, getting these glimpses during the day, just seeing what I saw, what, you know, death really is about, and how easy it is. And I said, wow. I just kept driving and just said, oh, wow. That's a big one. So I'm getting these huge, huge recognitions now, quite a few now, daily. And I just have to kind of say, wow, okay, that's great. And maybe this will lead to the whole complex just dropping away, all the defenses, defense systems, the whole complex of misery, actually, which is only a simulation, okay? It's only a simulation. We don't need a simulation. There's no knowledge. There's no knowledge in aimlessness. There's no knowledge in what can never be. There's nothing to know about what can never be at all. So do we really need knowledge about this universe? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. It's aimlessness. We don't need knowledge about aimlessness. So when this can really settle in and we can accept this, then there's no reason why the whole complex can't just drop away. I believe this is what Jesus is talking about. It can drop away overnight. When it's ready to go, you know, it can go. And it may very well be go time right now. And don't be worried if you're not ready to go. There are some that Jesus indicated are ready to go, and you may not know who they are at all, because really, when you have all these breakthroughs, you're in such a wow, you know, state of wow, full stop in the wow, that you just go about very humbly in the world, like you're just a nobody. You're very humble. You seem kind of stupid and slow-witted, and because you're in shock, actually. I'm in shock all day. All day today I was in severe shock, you know, of the wow. From just the breakthroughs that are happening so immense. And so people look at me like, I just, you know, it's just kind of like, you know, simpleton, you know. It's nothing there. But because I'm taking on the extreme shock, you know, to an extraordinary extent. And once this finally shock all wears off, then I'll certainly, may, you know, certainly be like a different presentation to the world. What's all the shock of the continuity fears evaporated? Then, you know, it's a different story, isn't it? And people might say, what in the world? You know, how is that possible? This person, are you kidding me? They didn't show any promise or anything. And but it's the ones in the world who seem to be real go-getters and world beaters and doing all this stuff, oftentimes they're not even tackling this continuity problem at all. See, and the ones that are the ones that seem to be very meek and lowly and just nothing to see here, because their minds are just stunned by what they're seeing. And they get a little glimpse and they get stunned again, another glimpse, stunned again. So you're always in this sort of semi-stunned condition. And so the world doesn't understand that you know, you're actually getting the job done. You're carrying the heavy weight. They don't see that at all. So maybe be very surprising, you know, who these people are that awaken to the now. Just people just like, huh? Where'd they come from? It's not the glamour people who are out in front necessarily getting all the attention right now. There are quite a few who are doing that, but their time may have come to an end when those who are abiding in the now come out into the world, then people realize, wow, there's a big difference. So let's go with a winner. Let's go with the safe way and the winning way here, what really works. But, you know, those who have been jumping in the spotlight in a big way in the world, they had their time on the stage. They had a lot of time on the stage, actually. So we don't need to feel sorry for them at all. You know, they did what they wanted to do, and they had their fun, they had their experiencing, and, you know, it's a new phase coming up now. The world is really entering a new phase, and you have to have those who are really, truly adept to help out with this phase. There's no question about it. This is Jesus' time, you know, Jesus and the apostles. This is an apostolic time, and because all the chips are going to be on the table. And people are going to get serious. They're going to say, you know, hey, I really have to make a decision of what am I going to do? I mean, this is the time for fooling around. Is you know, basically, you know, the bet has been called. Everything's all in, and you have to decide: are you going to fold, or are you going to go all in too? This is the time we're in, and you know, we need to go all in with spiritual practice and say, okay, let's see which way turns out to be what I really want. And in its spiritual practice, is going to be the way what we really want. It's the path of remembering how much we love reality rather than forgetting. That's the important path. And so some might say, well, it's a heavy burden, heavy burden, heavy burden. I've been listening to this song by the Hollies, He Ain't Heavy, He's My Brother, which was a very great song back, I think it was in 1969, 70, or somewhere around there, 71. It's very popular in the Vietnam War, I remember. He ain't heavy, he's my brother, and on we go, we can do it. The burden is not heavy. When you abide in the now, the burden will not be heavy. It will be light. It will be a light burden. And so many will be helped. And so we're on the cusp of this right now. So I've been doing as much as I can do to warn people to prepare, 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 prepare. Hopefully there are some that have prepared, even in little ways, listening a little bit and having some of it sink in. And then when those who are able to really bear the burden through abiding, truly abiding in the now, full stopped in the now, those who are fully stopped in the now, full stop in the now, there are many able to say, okay, this is what we're going to do now. Yes, the troubles are upon the world, and yet we're not going to be troubled by these troubles, actually. We have the truth, and we can practice what we need to practice. We can have right focus. Even though the world's collapsing all around us, we can have right focus, and we're going to be okay. Just like Jesus was standing on the side of this mountain, the whole mountain was crumbling around him, but he wasn't moving at all. He was not affected by it in the slightest bit. So I absolutely believe that many can be helped, and they will be helped. And they can have the discipline, they can have the will, they can practice. It's not so difficult once you get started. Once you make the breakthrough into starting, you say, wow, why didn't I do this before? I can do this. I can do this. Like practicing a musical instrument, you'd say, no, I can't do it, I'm not musical, blah, blah, blah. And finally you decide you got to. And you sit down and you start doing a few things and you realize, hey, it's not as difficult as I thought, not nearly as difficult. So we can certainly do this. I am now, there is no me. I am now, there is no me. All this electromagnetic, this magnetic electroism, magneto-electricism, magnetic electroism, me, our magnetic electric home is what? Me, magnetic electro home is just me. It's not our home. It's not my home. I am now. Now is my home. Time, a simulation of time, is not my home at all. Why am I asking myself to live in, to believe my home is in a simulation of what we think time is going to be? How is that my home? It's not my home. It's never been my home. Never will be my home. So I am now. There is no, I am not me. There is no me. I am now. I am now. Full stop in the now. I am now. My home is not in the me. Me is not my home. Me is not my home. Magnetic electro, electric, magneto, magnetic electro home is not my home. It's not my home. This universe is the magneto electric universe is not my home. I don't dwell there. I dwell in the now. I don't dwell in a simulation of time. I dwell in now, which is a simulation of time not starting, instead of a simulation of time starting. See, simulation of no kingdom of time. Instead of a simulation of a kingdom of time, we dwell in a simulation of no kingdom of time, or the kingdom of now. So we dwell in the kingdom of now. So we may wake up one morning and we say, wow, where am I? Oh, I'm in the kingdom of now. I'm in the kingdom of now. Dwelling, I am now, I am now. I dwell in the kingdom of now. I'm full stopped in the now. Full stopped in the now. In other words, I'm not trying to go into time at all. I'm fully stopped in the now. I am fully stopped in the now. I am fully stopped in the now. I am fully stopped in the now. Yes, I already know that I am already full stopped in the now. Yes, I already know that I am already full stopped in the now. Yes, I already know that I am already full stopped in the now. Yeah, I am. Yes, I know. I am already full stopped in the now. Yes, I already know that I am already full stopped in the now. I am full stopped in the now. I am full stop in the now. I am full stop in the now. Yes, I already know. I'm already full stopped in the now. Yes, I already know. I am already full stopped in the now. Or just full stop in the now. I am already full stop in the now. Yes, I already know. I am already dwelling in the kingdom of now. Yes, I already know that I am already dwelling in the kingdom of now. Now, what I find is that explanations are attempt to struggle with the continuity fear, the wow feeling, the wow. And this is what we must not do. We must not struggle with it. We must just allow it to settle in and then keep practicing. Allow it to settle in, keep practicing. Otherwise, it's easy to get lost in discussions. And those always deteriorate and deteriorate and deteriorate. It's much better to simply don't struggle with it. Just accept it. Accept the burden. I am full stop in the now. I am full stop. In the now. I am full stop in the now. I am now. I am now. Yes, I already know that 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 I am now. So, Yes, I already know. Full stop in the kingdom of now. I am. Full stop in the kingdom of now. Yes, I already know that I am. Full stop in the kingdom of now. I am. Full stop in the kingdom of now. Imagine you're driving a car and the car comes to a complete stop. It's not going at 10 miles an hour, 5 or 4, 3 or 2 or 1. It is absolutely fully stopped in the now. There's no more momentum trying to go anywhere. Trying to know anything about time. But trying to know anything that doesn't about doesn't what can never exist, fully stopped in the now. I am full stop in the now. 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 Concrete. Full stop in the now. Dirt. Full stop in the now. Hills. Full stop in the now. Stones, full stop in the now. Rocks, full stop in the now. Mountains, full stop in the now. Rivers, full stop in the now. Plains, full stop in the now. Oceans, full stop in the now. Islands, full stop in the now. Land, full stop in the now. Land, full stop in the now. So we want our universe to reflect to us this preparation for time to never start, which is the now. Reflect to us the now. And gratitude, great gratitude for this. We're sending gratitude to ourselves. Okay, so, you know, don't be surprised. Keep practicing, keep practicing. The world's going to do what it's going to do. Don't be too concerned about it. The main thing is to take refuge in practice right now. This is the advice. This is the advice. Take refuge in practice. Spiritual practice. I am full stop in the now. I am not in the me. The me is an aimless dream simulation, aimless dress rehearsal for what can never be. An aimless dress rehearsal for what can never be. I am not me, I am now. I am not me, I am now. I am not me, I am now. I am not me. I'm not this magnetic electro dream dress rehearsal house, kingdom dress rehearsal house. I am not this magnetic electro dream dress rehearsal for what can never be. I am not that at all. I am now. I dwell in the kingdom of now. The magnetic electro universe has nothing to do with my kingdom of now, have a kingdom of now. Nothing to do with it. It is not my home at all. I am not me, I am now. I am not me, I am not now. I am now. I am not me, I am now. The magnetic electro universe is a dream, simulation of a simulating a dress rehearsal, preparing us for time to start. that we are imagining. It has nothing to do with our identities, actually, our reality at all. It's not the way reality is at all. It's just a bizarre simulation, dress rehearsal for time. You know, it is complete. This universe is absolutely bizarre, and it has nothing to do with reality. It's the stuff of our imagination, our dreams, believing that the time is going to start, so we need a way to prepare for this, being completely unfamiliar with it. Of course we're unfamiliar with it. It's never been and never will be. How can we be familiar with it? It's not possible, really. And this dream simulation is not actually getting us familiar with time, because time doesn't exist. So this whole dream simulation is actually just aimlessness, arrogant aimlessness. AA, arrogant aimlessness. It really is. And in that way, we're all Alcoholics Anonymous, aren't we? We're all AA. We've been trapped in aimless arrogance, and yet we have the tools to give a different purpose to this aimless. Instead of aimless arrogance, we now can use the props of this dream universe, give it a different purpose of preparing us for time to never start. And in truth, time certainly can never start, because it doesn't exist. God did not create time. And we cannot create it either. Aimless arrogance. That's all we've been involved with. Aimless arrogance. So what do we need to know about aimless arrogance? What do we need to know about aimless arrogance? Yes, I already know that I don't need to know anything about aimless arrogance. There's nothing to know. Yes, I already know that there's nothing to know about aimless arrogance. Yes, I already know I don't need to know anything about aimless arrogance, because there's nothing to know. Ultimately, it's aimed at knowing about time, and there is no time. So, yes, I already know that there's nothing. I don't need to know anything about aimless arrogance, because there's nothing to know. Yes, I already know that I don't need to know anything about aimless arrogance, because there's nothing to know. Now, I know that a lot of the talk in the world for a long time about the sky is falling is promoted by those who sell precious metals, because that they tell people, hey, look, this is where your safety is going to be. Well, so you think, well, maybe they're just inventing all these troubles. Not necessarily. Certainly they have that's their business to get people to buy their metals. I'm not involved in that at all. Not one bit. I have no dog in this hunt whatsoever. So I'm not saying what I'm saying because I'm trying to sell somebody medals or anything like that. Not at all. But it doesn't automatically make them wrong, though. Okay. They maybe it's like people here in California selling earthquake supplies. Why? Well, they say, well, there's going to be an earthquake, and there will be someday, for sure. People sell stuff saying that there's going to be, disasters, etc. And of course, they play up the idea of disasters. Not always wrong, in hurricane season, they might say this is going to be a particularly bad hurricane season, and buy your plywood so you can board up your windows, et cetera, and people say, yeah, I better prepare for that, and then turns out maybe it's a terrible hurricane season. They need, Katrina comes in, they need to board up their houses and do stuff, and so they prepared properly. So I don't have any economic advice to give anybody about what they should do. I don't have any money myself, so it's kind of, for me, I don't ever think about it. Such things like investing or what to do or anything like that. I think that the spiritual abiding in the now is the safety what we need, actually. Abiding in the now, and anyone can do that. It doesn't cost anything to do it, actually. So, and we don't have to read everything about all these articles of people predicting doom here, doom there. we just need to keep on focusing on right spiritual practice, because even if there isn't any troubles to come in this world, which is rather unlikely, you'd still be moving quickly towards abidance in now, which is freedom from this hideous dream dress rehearsal for the kingdom of time, which is such a hideous rehearsal. So it's a complete win, total win. So it's not like, you know, you'd be losing if the world doesn't go through all sorts of troubles. You wouldn't be, you'd still be in, you know, total win. You're going towards total win. So can't be any down, there's no downside to that at all, actually. I'm just saying, you know, it's not a good idea to keep procrastinating. Never is in this world, right? If you just look at the history of this world, when has procrastination ever been a smart tactic, actually? Yeah. Always, the history of this world, troubles always come. Always. Never can you point out and say, no troubles have come. No, it has never worked out that way in this world. And because it's a simulation for the kingdom of time, preparing us for that. And the kingdom of time is inherently problematic. The biggest problem is it doesn't exist. So how can you dwell in a kingdom that doesn't exist? Very problematical, huh? So I'm just saying, don't procrastinate. This is always the message I've been given. Jesus gave me this message long ago. Don't procrastinate. Go. No procrastinating. You know, break through that procrastination. And, you know, there may be those who think they can cure it all by singing songs, lovely songs, and go or travel around, and people say, oh, okay, you know, I think things are going to be fine in the world. We've you know, doesn't seem that that's taking place. It doesn't really seem to be working very well. I would say right spiritual practice is the way. This really puts you more in control of your dream than you realize. Keep in mind, we're in control of our dream. Everybody has this separate dream, actually. It's both collective and separate, because perception is that way. Nobody perceives the same universe at all. No one, not any. So that's the nature of perception. So the universe, our dream universe, will, we can change the purpose of it, and we can have a safe dream universe, a wonderful dream universe for ourselves, that help us prepare to realize that time will never start. Which is, you know, the kingdom of now. We can dwell in the kingdom of now, even though we walk this world, and, you know, and others are dwelling in the king in the simulation for the kingdom of time. We're dwelling in a dream that was a simulation of the kingdom of now. Let's put it that way: a simulation of the kingdom of now, preparing us for the kingdom of now, which is reality. And we're walking the same world, but we're in different universes, actually, different purposes. We're both still dreaming, both still in a simulation, but different purposes and different simulations, different purpose for the simulation. So, and Jesus tells us, yeah, this is so. And it's hard for us to understand, but all this is just our imagination, a dream, a perception. So what is it that what kind of laws do we have to overcome in order to do this? None whatsoever. It's all our simple, it's our will, is it's it. Our will is not bound at all, actually. So all we have to do is just decide, make these decisions, and then deal with our continuity fear as we go along. So there can be quite a variance in what we're perceiving. We don't have to perceive the world through the senses of the body. The senses of the body are part of this dress rehearsal for the kingdom of time. That the ideas that we will be experiencing through sensory experiencing through the flesh. This is our belief of what the kingdom of time will be like. We don't have to experience through the flesh at all. It's just a dream we're dreaming. flesh doesn't even have to be involved in experiencing, in seeing, in hearing. No, doesn't have to be at all. Doesn't even need food, actually, or sleep. We can just dream that it's perfectly sustained by this dream simulation of preparing us for the kingdom now. Absolutely, we can do that. We can even have the body just appear as a light. That's also just still a dream. There's no reason why we cannot. We can dream whatever we want to dream, actually. But dreams are start from a premise, from a purpose. So our purpose has to accept the premise, the purpose of this is of our dream is now to prepare us for time to never start, prepare us for the kingdom of now. This is not rocket science at all, actually. It's very simple. It just we're stunned because we thought we're so used to complexity. We're so used to getting ready for the kingdom of time, which we feel to be infinite complexity. We feel that our happiness somehow is the mastery of infinite complexity. And we're hearing now our happiness has to do with just very simple use of our spiritual will. That's it. It's very simple. So it's quite shocking for us. Quite shocking. We said, wow, I could have done that. Why did I delay? It's so easy. Well, because the continuity concerns and this desperate, our arrogance creates a massive amount of desperate fear in us, thinking that we have to get ready for the kingdom of time, that somehow we've been expelled from the kingdom of now, and which we haven't. There's nowhere to expel us to. How can everywhereness expel anything? It cannot. So for the most part, if you're not practicing, you're in the wow, which is to be quiet. And then when you get out, let the wow dissipate a bit, then you can go back to practicing. And then when you practice successfully, you'll feel the wow will rise again and be quiet, and then go back to practicing. So this is a taking refuge in practice. You can do this. You can do it. You absolutely can do this. And so you might seem to the world like, oh, wow, look at that quiet little mouse. You know, they don't seem to have anything to say. But really, you've been practicing, you know, and coming across this tremendous wow, and then you're just quiet. And the ego might scream, this isn't how we prepare for time. You know, this is all wrong. Well, guess what? We're not preparing for time. This is how we prepare for the kingdom of now, actually. This is how we prepare for the kingdom of now. They've called it the kingdom of heaven in the past. Prepare for the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Prepare for it. Kingdom of heaven is now. I think the kingdom of heaven is at hand was actually maybe a misinterpretation. It should, at hand means right here, right now. It really should have been the kingdom of heaven is now. It's the kingdom of now. The kingdom of heaven is the kingdom of now. I don't struggle with you know, the words like what is now, what do you mean? You'll catch a glimpse of it, and then you realize, oh, okay, wow, yeah. So, the kingdom of heaven is now. The kingdom of heaven is the kingdom of now. The kingdom of heaven is the kingdom of now. I am now. I am now. I am now. Reality still is real, so we'll certainly catch glimpses of it. Don't worry. It's not like we have to give birth or create the nowness. It's already God created. It's already present, actually. So we just need to awaken from this, change the purpose of this simulation to preparing us for the kingdom of now. So stones, you now, you dwell in the kingdom of now. Pebbles, you dwell in the kingdom of now. Released into the kingdom of now. Trail, released into the kingdom of now. Liberated into the kingdom of now. Vegetation, liberated as the kingdom of now. Hillside, liberated as the kingdom of now. Liberated in the kingdom of now. Be ye liberated in the kingdom of now. However you want to say it. Rocks, liberated in the kingdom of now. Liberated in the now. Trees, liberated in the now. Vistas, liberated in the now. Landscape, liberated in the now. Earth, liberated in the now. Dust, liberated in the now. All world, liberated into the kingdom of now. Full stop in the now. And don't worry about exactly what it means, because as we practice it, eventually, you know, you'll start getting little glimpses. You'll just suddenly see something. You say, oh gosh, oh my gosh, wow, I see it. And then, of course, the continuity fear will come rushing in, and you say, oh, okay, and just keep practicing. Calm down a bit, then practice, calm down a bit, practice. When you're practicing, you're not thinking about writing a book, okay? Forget about that. You're not thinking about that at all. You're thinking about just feeling the intensity of the practice. You're not trying to write a book. This can be difficult for those who want to write a book, because the whole idea is to develop the intensity so much and then the wow feeling, and then just be quiet, neutral. Don't think about anything. And then back to practice. So you stay away from trying to organize your thoughts into like a book form. At this point, if there's any book writing, let it be from those who are already abiding in the now. I would say, if there's to be any book writing at all, who's to say that there will be? So let the book writers be the book writers. If they're liberated in that they dwell in the kingdom of now, and they're guided to write a book, let them do that. But the rest of you practice, and don't try to organize your thoughts in a book form, in an outline form, in a detailed form. It's holistic. That when you glimpse the truth, it's all embracing. It's holistic. It defies linear, book depiction. It defies it. You cannot stuff it into a book. There are no books in the now. No books in the now. No books in the now. The now is not a book. There are no books in the now. I am 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 now. nothing tastes better than water that is just naturally cooled by the evening coolness. This water just sits outside, and it seems to be just the right temperature. Whereas, like, you put it in the refrigerator, it always, to me, it's always too cold, and kind of dehydrates my mouth. But just the natural temperature of an evening is really good. Remember when you used to be able to drink water out of streams? Yeah, absolutely. We weren't worried about, you know, all the stuff we're so worried about now. Ridiculous. I am now. So we give a different purpose. All pollution released in the now. All pollution released in the now. All contamination released in the now. They're finding our food is so contaminated, you know, we say all contamination released in the now. All everything released in the now. All viruses released in the now. All parasites released in the now. All troubles released in the now. So the world news is going to become so intense that you're either going to get sucked into that, or you're going to decide to give it everything you've got to practice. One of the two, because if you start trying to pay attention to the news, you're going to get so sucked into it. You say, wow, this is too much. I can't do both. I can't do both because the storylines are so different, right? You know, it's the storyline of the world crumbling like this. It's just, I mean, I'm looking at this dream, I said, oh my gosh, how can I even depict that or follow it? It's just so overwhelming. You know, it's just, you have to see it to believe it. So you have to decide, am I going to really become absorbed in this world's troubles, or become absorbed in changing the purpose of this dream simulation? One of the two. So if you're practicing already not paying attention to the world, that's very good. That's very good. I've done that on and off my whole life, taking periods of time where you just completely drop out of the news and you have no idea what's going on in the world. I've done that over and over. It's very good practice. And you realize, I can function just fine. In fact, I feel better. I don't even know. Maybe I should do that again right now. I don't know. It's possible. You don't look at any news, don't listen to any news, and go through like a week like that, and just, what's going on? I don't know. It's fine, you feel fine, not a problem. I feel better, actually. Interesting, I was at this place today, and someone was talking about this wood, and how you have to seal this wood with wax. This product you put on the ends of this wood so water doesn't get into it. And these people were there, and they said, oh, but we already sealed it with a stain. And now, putting the wax over it isn't any good. It's not going to work, actually. The stain is not a good enough sealer for the ends of the wood. And they said, it's too late. We already did it. So I'd say if you keep paying attention to the world, it'll kind of seal you in a certain way where your attention is not able to you can't pay attention to spiritual practice. You can't put it in the right context at all. Can't focus on it. So like the wax would, you know, prevent the world from getting into us. Whereas if you pay too much attention to the news, you think you're sealing things, but you're not, and the world will get into you. World will get into if you don't really seal it properly. Spiritual practice is the proper sealant for our situation. It's the proper sealant. I am now. I am now. I've never been me. I'm not me. I am now. I've never been me. Me is just an aimless dress rehearsal for what will never be. So it feels great to practice like this. It feels like you're doing the right, doing what's right. I have never been me. I am now. I'm not me. I've never been me. I am now. I am not me. Me is an aimless dress rehearsal of what will never be. I've never been me. I've always been now. See, a dream of what I am is not what I am. And this magnetic electro simulation is a dream. It's not what I am. I am now. I'm not in time. I am now. There is no time, so I am now. I am not me. Me is an aimless dress rehearsal for what will never be. We may be, like spiritual medics, having to pull people off the battlefield when they just hit, and we bring them back to, the dispensary, the triage, and medical facilities, and help them recover by engaging in right spiritual practice. There may be many refugees, actually spiritual refugees, coming up. And they may be in bad shape, really. People are on the edge. A lot of people are on the edge, still functioning, but they lack the will, for right spiritual practice. They lack the will. They can say, I can just do that. That's sure easy. But when time comes, will they have the will to do it? If they really had the will to do it, they'd be doing it now. You would think, why wait for the inevitable? We're going to. We'll all be dwelling in the kingdom of now. It's a certainty. So since it's inevitable, why postpone it? Why, for what? What do we get out of postponing it? What value do we really get out of postponing it? Judging, looking for value in aimlessness, aimless arrogance, trying to find value in aimless arrogance. There's no value there. So there's nothing to be gained by postponing it. People say, "Oh yeah, I can do that," but when the time comes, I'll do it. But right now, I'm enjoying, pursuing value in the world. And well, don't be too sure. Bad habits are difficult to break. Bad habits are very difficult to break. And so, the wise are rehearsing, practicing, spiritual practicing. They're doing it. They're considering it. They're listening. They're saying, "Let me ease into this. I can do it." And start doing it. Those are the wise. And there may be many who are following the goddess who tells them that she'll save them, and then when time comes to do right spiritual practice, goddess doesn't know how to do that at all. Can't give right spiritual practice, because the goddess is really aiming to dispirit us all. And that's the idea of goddesses, the idea of our aimless arrogance is to completely forget about reality and admit that we can never go back, that it was all just a dream, that reality was a dream. Essentially, the idea of salvation that the ego puts forth is that we have to accept that reality was actually just a dream, and that time is reality. So when troubles start, those who have been following the ego, they may be praying in the ego in the form of like the goddess, and they'll find out that they can't, you know, whatever they say, there's no power to it. There's no truth to it. There's no true wow to it. You know, it doesn't work. And they'll say, oh my gosh, it doesn't work. And then the gods will say, yeah, it's because reality is just a myth. But now I'm helping save you by showing you this truth that reality is only a myth, and now you'll be able to fully embrace time. So don't worry. And then people think, oh, okay. And this is how you go down into darkness, thinking that you're actually succeeding. You know, very much so. So I say, put your attention on Jesus. If Jesus shows up in your dream, put your attention on that. Jesus certainly knows the way, certainly knows all the truth, certainly knows how to help us practice, no doubt about it. There are others too who are very adept at practice. I put up on this channel three of them: Longchenpa, Jesus, Ramana Maharshi. These are three great sources who know the truth, and who know how important practice is, and they know, you know, various forms of very helpful practice, and they encourage us to take refuge in practice. These are the ones that really encourage us to take refuge in practice. Remember, it's not about trying to figure out a way in the kingdom of time to make assertions and affirmations to get rich, to get help, to be healthy, and all this kind of stuff. That's the false path. The true path is to change the purpose of your dream, and now it's preparing us for the kingdom of time, where everything supports us. We have everything, every instant, actually. We cannot possibly suffer any want. We're not vulnerable at all. This is what real salvation is about. So there may be a lot of who, as the world crumbles, you know, will be spending time asserting, like, I deserve to have $1 million today. I deserve $1 million, you know, that kind of prosperity, affirmation sort of stuff. Yeah, that's not the way. That is not the way. That's the Antichrist way, actually. That's the ego arrogance way of trying to use the crisis to say, hey, this is how the kingdom of time is going to be, but don't worry. In the kingdom of time, all you have to do is assert what you want, and you'll be able to get what you want. But if it doesn't work well, you just weren't asserting properly or something. Or, you know. So, again, we are focused on changing the purpose of our dream, which we're absolute sovereigns. We have absolute capacity and right to do so. Change it into now a dream that is preparing us for time to never start, preparing us for the kingdom of now. I am now. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. I am now. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. I am now. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. You know, this is the assertion. So in other words, in this dream simulation of preparing us for the kingdom now, there is no want, there is no scarcity, there is no need. The flesh is does not some interference that is needy at all. You're sustained by the pure spaciousness, by the nowness. There's an inherent, natural sustaining of I am. So this is what we're aiming for. This is the true refuge. Okay, starting to get a little late here. I'm not going to go full 2 hours and 30 minutes. So remember, don't struggle with the wow. If you feel quiet and like, I just don't feel like my mind, that's okay. That's okay. That's the shock of the wow, is you're making efforts to listen to truth, which is shocking. Because you say, why didn't I do this before? It's not that difficult. And that's kind of shocking. And then you say, well, I am doing it now. That's kind of shocking. That's great. Don't struggle with it. Don't struggle with it. Just remain meek, humble, severely modest. Modest in your appearance. Don't draw attention to yourself, in appearance-wise, physically-wise. Just try to quietly go about your day and just be in character and don't try to excel, because you're in shock, the shock of the wow. And as you have this attitude, you will then have little glimpses of freedom, little glimpses of like, wow. Now I see how this, how I've been trapped by this dream of praying for time. I see how it's all such an insidious trap. Wow. And you get more and more clear about that. You say, I don't want that. That doesn't do me any good at all. Holy cow. All right. So I'm gonna go to sleep tonight, and hopefully some of the wow will dissipate. But like yesterday and today, I'm just shaking. You know, sort of, I can feel this trembling and shakiness. So, you know, fairly traumatic. What all these breakthroughs are, fairly traumatic actually, and just have to again remain meek and humble. And just put yourself through it. It's not that bad. Not that bad at all. Okay, very great. I am now. I am now. I am now. And